You messed up. Yeah. What?
Yo, what's good?
Where the white one?
Oh yes, the white people are gone. Finally. Wait. Yeah, you lied. You lied. He was here. Wait, you're not getting an interview? You're gonna leave?
Clean up the story.
Ah, okay. You know what? I got it. All right. Congratulations, sir. That was a well played grand finals. Shout outs to your mentality. Game one, you got smacked. You got three stock pretty hard, but you took your time, put your head down, drank your water. You took your time. What was going through your head after that first game?
McBee, you're kind of in the shot.
McBee, go over there. There we go.
Yeah, I got three stocked that game one. I was like, what the heck am I in for? You know, like,
and for Yoshi shenanigans.
I've been going to a lot more Denton locals recently, so I've been like getting used to fighting Denton people.
Yeah.
You know, the McBees, the Jammas, the Capi, the Tispi. So okay. Fighting an invader from West Texas that just pretty much came unexpectedly.
Yeah.
Like, it was just like, I really felt like I had to dig deep. Like, you know, new character. Well, like
you change your combo
a month wise, but yeah, like, you know, just like pretty much having to learn that matchup and Yellow Relo on the fly, like as Palu, like,
yeah,
opposed to like Cloud or Lucina in the past. It was just like really, really tough.
Were you thinking of switching game one? Because I mean, I thought you were gonna do that, but you decided, you know what, the power's gonna do it. I'm rocking with this character. So
I mean, it's like deep in the back of my mind, like I could switch characters, but
yeah,
I don't think I'm ever going to. Like,
you're just gonna toughen it out and be like, you know what, I got three stock, gain two, we'll figure it out. And you did.
Yeah.
So,
and I mean, I'm pretty sure Relo is actually positive on my Cloud, he's positive on my Lucina as well. So like, you know, it was just like a matter of, I need to learn how to fight him right now, you know, not really like, I guess, rely on counter picks. Like,
yeah,
I really only go different characters in doubles. Like, I like solo maining in singles. I feel like just like forcing yourself to learn matchups and you know, all that jazz, just,
yeah,
like, I think it's the best way to improve.
Yeah. So yeah, I think that's, I agree with that. You know, you could just switch and, you know, opt for the counter pick, or opt for, you know, hey, Yoshi doesn't like swords that often, you know, I can just do this. But you decide, you know what, I need to learn Palutena. I recently picked up this character. This is a matchup and a player I just don't see often. So I have to do it now. If not now, then maybe never.
Yeah.
So that, shout outs to you, you know, sticking to your guns right there.
Appreciate
and opting
it,
you know, for the Palutena. So how's this week been for you in terms of tournament wise? You know, how did you feel going into Freaks 109?
I feel pretty confident going to the Denton locals. At Freaks, my lowest placing as Palu is third. At Redline, my lowest was fifth. So I think I'm doing like decently consistent here.
Yeah, that's pretty good placing.
Yeah, like, you know, I was like prepared to, you know, fight the same pretty much four people that I fight all the time. You know, it's like the Denton like winners semis. It's pretty much like always like, it's like between like McBee, Kappus, Tispi, Jamma. You know, the same people, but. You know, like when I heard Relo was coming, like, you know, I knew there was a chance that I would have to be like, you know, forced out of my comfort zone. And, you know, it was uncomfortable. It was very uncomfortable,
yeah,
as you can tell by that game one. But like,
yeah, but
I think this is the kind of thing that makes you stronger.
Yeah, you needed that discomfort because, again, like you said, this is a foreign player for this region, and you don't get to fight this character a lot at that level. So
yeah,
you know, shout outs to you sticking with that character.
And like, all things considered, I think Palu wins that matchup. Now Relo's like, he's pretty good at it. Like,
yeah,
he did beat Zai at Ultimatum. Zai is number two in Louisiana. He's
okay,
a really, really solid player. So like, you know, Relo, you know, he's fought his share of Palu. So,
yeah, I imagine everyone has some kind of PAL experience.
Yeah, but at the same time, he said he didn't feel like Zaya. I think he said he didn't feel like Zaya played the matchup too correctly.
Mm-hmm.
Like, so I was just like really trying to like analyze like what are Yoshi's, you know, specific weaknesses, what are Palu's specific strengths, like how can I abuse that as much as possible.
Yeah,
and you know, The answer was back air.
Yeah, the answer was back air.
Back air.
Yeah, you showed your back a lot more in that matchup. You wouldn't try to really nair too often. The only time you really naired is if he double jumped towards you and had no more armor, and you could just go, okay, I can nair this guy and get something going. And your nair strings weren't as long as you were used to.
Yeah.
So you had to really cut things off. I mean, there was a lot of adjustments. I even said this about McBee, where he had to adjust his combo game on the fly. Like, Yoshi's a character that forced you to play differently. In this game and in Smash in general, there are plenty of characters that force you to play differently. Yoshi being one of them, and you learn on the fly. McBee was learning on the fly. It's just that, like, there's so many layers to, like, what they can do with their strengths as that character to make you play differently. Like, you saw the double jump armor. Like, you know, there were times where he would, like, drift towards you really late and just eat the back or eat the nair and then just upper out of there or nair out of there or something like that. So, you know, there was a lot of adjustments that you just had to do on the fly. Okay, he's changing up his double jump patterns to get armor later on so he can save it. Or, you know, maybe he'll just be a bit more campy with the eggs. But you had a good answer with the reflect, and you didn't opt for auto reticle that often because, again, Yoshi's airspeed is just insane, and he's just there.
Yeah, I feel like Yoshi does really great against projectiles. Like, he's not going to struggle really against zoners, but...
Yeah, he can just ignore them.
You know, with his airspeed just darting around everywhere, but...
Yeah.
He does struggle when he comes face-to-face with you and your hitboxes just out-prioritize them.
Yeah, I would say that's the deal. Like, if you're able to box with him and, you know, break his armor many times over and have an aerial, like, you know, palo backer just go through it, then I say that's a pretty good game plan. But... Gonna wrap it up right here. So this is Cheeks. He is the winner of Freaks 109. He took it over Yellarella, the invader, so he was able to hold down the fort and defend Freaks.
Alright. Parting words of wisdom. It doesn't have to be about Smash.
Yeah, life. Anything?
Zillion said stuff. Now you get to say stuff. It's my new favorite.
Alright.
Let's go, black people. That's our word of wisdom. Okay, I'm kidding.
Go get yourselves a fade, because... I got myself a fade, this haircut, you know, a couple of weeks ago, and my confidence has just skyrocketed. Like, I think I've asked like 3 girls out in this past 1 or 2 weeks. It's ridiculous. Like, there's a lot of self confidence that goes along with hair.
Yeah,
you know, don't feel self conscious if you're like balding, you know, male pattern baldness, whatever, you know. Take care of your hair. You know, clean yourself up. You know, good hygiene, shower, brush your teeth, all that. And I mean,
do you want to name him?
You will feel like you can get any girl, take any man's woman. Like,
oh, wait a minute! Whoa! You said asking out, not taking women. Jeez, be respectful, man. You're supposed to be a gent.
I mean, some of these girls in Denton, they need a thug in their life. You know? I mean, straight up, you know.
They need a thug in their life, man.
I mean,
my man.
Okay, I'm done. Cut him off the mic.
That's it for us. That's, you know, Freak's very own Cheeks. He's your winner, and that's it. And just get a fade. Yeah. If you're me, get your locks redone.
Oh,
I like my locks.